Dear learners, in continuation to our discussion of targeting the journal for our research article, the next factor is availability, online or offline. See, if a journal is online or offline, is it available online? Then it would be good for you. Many reputed journals are offline only. But you have to choose depending upon your priority, that in which kind of journal you want to get published. In arts and humanities and in social sciences, many reputed journals are still not online, but they have got the prestige, that repo in the field. So it is your choice, but remember, only the online journals are cited highly, not the offline journals articles. So if you'll go for online, you will be cited more. So choice is yours. And to add this discussion on online and offline, you know, with the online journals, the article processing is very easy in the online format. So you need not to spend anything. You need not to take the printouts of your articles. You can very easily submit it. So this is also a plus. Apart from the advantages of getting the more citations, it's another advantage that is easy to submit your manuscript with the online journals. Dear learners, now comes another aspect, indexing. A journal might not have good impact factor, but if it is having good indexing in various major indexing agencies like Chemical Abstracts, PubMed, Embase, and Web of Science and other services, you can target them also. You must have your own priority whether you want to get published in the high impact. If you are not able to target the high impact journal of your field, you can also target a journal which is not having the high impact but is having good indexing. This we have also discussed earlier, but it's very important. That's why I'm emphasizing on this point again. Now we will move to the another aspect, format. What kind of format a journal is having for their article? See the author's guidelines. See, check whether the appearance or the format of the journal recommended for the articles is suitable for you or not. You can check the typeface, style used in citing references. Check it out whether it suits you or not with respect to your study or the research work. If relevant, if found suitable, does the journal publish short and or rapid communications? In case you have planned a short communication, whether the journal has that segment or not. Sometimes the journal don't publish a short communication. You will have to check it out. So check the format. And the last but not the least aspect is APC, article processing charges. If you can afford it, go ahead. Most of the journals generally don't ask for the article processing charges, the journals which are prestigious and reputed one. But even the prestigious and reputed articles, reputed journals ask for the APC if they are publishing the article in the open access form. So you will have to bear that thing. However, some international agencies provide that fund to the author for publishing their article in the open access form. Some journal charge for fast processing of article. So you will have to check it out that whether the journal charge for the processing or not. If it is charging, whether the charge is being before the decision or after the decision. If you can pay, you will have also have to check it out. Sometimes another tip I'm going to give you, that try to float a mail If your article seems to be promising, they can also waive the charges. Sometimes they waive the charges, especially for the third world countries. Many of the publishers don't charge anything. So dear learners, now let us summarize this module. We discussed what are the research articles, why they are important, and we studied the steps of research article writing. We studied planning the research article and targeting our research article for suitable journal. These are the very important aspects. So plan and target wisely depending on the factors we discussed. We will discuss other aspects of writing research article in the next module. Stay tuned for the next module.